this show and the old show is the opportunity for us to present this world as it was originally conceived is a greater opportunity. Obviously, they didn't have the money or the time back then to do what they really wanted to do. I think the icons of the show, that blue police box, the doctor in that magnificent costume, his sonic screwdriver, those are things that are icons of the show, and those are things that the BBC expected us to keep. And without them, we really don't have Doctor Who. But in terms of tailoring it to an American audience, we've really created two movies. We have a science fiction movie for the fans that is a wonderful adventure for the Doctor. But we also have a sort of love story wrapped into it, very much reminiscent of Romancing the Stone, in sort of feel and fun. So what we've done is we've tailored it to two audiences. There's something there for the fans, and there's something there for people who really don't know what Doctor Who is. And I think we've done a lovely job of kissing the past, bringing it into the 90s, and evolving this concept into a story and a show that I think can appeal to a broad audience. There's a very rich underground following for Doctor Who. There are very large clubs in major cities throughout the country. Chicago, which is a major Fox affiliate, has one of the largest clubs in the country. And in fact, the online service has its own place for Doctor Who. But also Fox is the right place for it because its audience does enjoy things like Alien Nation and X-Files, as you said. And I think the demographic base for this is right on target. I mean, it's absolutely their audience. So it couldn't